Today, it's a privilege for me to share the message with you guys in behalf of our senior pastor, Bishop Ariel, and Pastora Geraldine. And today, our message, this message is entitled, We Need Each Other. You know, guys, I would like to share my journey inside the church and how the church and how the people inside the church helped me so much in growing in my relationship with God. Yesterday, sa Tarnate, someone asked me, sabi niya sa akin, Kuya, for how long have you been in this church? And I answered, sabi ko, I've been here for 13 years now. From the time that someone entered in our classroom, just like most of you guys, someone entered and shared the gospel to me. That was during college. I received Christ in my life. And from that day on, until this day, I never regret a single moment of my life that I have accepted Jesus as the Lord and the Savior of my life. And this church really helped me a lot para lumago sa pananampalataya. At alam ko, itong mga katabi ninyo, these people will bring out the best also to you. And that is also my prayer, that ikaw din naman, you will bring out the best to that person right beside you. Tingnan mo siya. Sa palagay mo, tutulong ba yan? Or... We need each other. You know, guys, the people is yet to see how the church should collaborate, how the church should connect one another and see the power of us being together. Hindi pa nakikita. At kailangan ipakita natin kung paano ang mga Kristiyano magsama-sama to fulfill one purpose, to fulfill one goal, and that is to evangelize this whole world, to share the gospel to every nation, to for us to advance the kingdom of God. Ang sabi nga ni Bishop Ariel, I remember that we are not just only for the campus, we're not just only for the marketplace or for the families, but we are here for global transformation. Amen. Amen. Who believes that? Konti lang ang convinced. Who are convinced? Amen. And you know, one person cannot do it. Hindi kaya ng isang tao. Hindi kaya ng isang tao to win a nation. We need a group. We need a congregation. We need a lot. We need each other para gawin ang isang bagay na ito. I would like to open and read this in the Bible in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 10. It says there, each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. Each of you, every one of us, hindi siya, hindi yung magtuturo, pero every one of us should use whatever gifts, kung ano yung meron tayo, whatever that God has given us. Anong binigay sa iyo ng God na talent? Anong binigay sa iyo ng God na resources? Anong binigay sa iyo ng God na skills? So, let's use it, whatever that we have received, to serve others. Encircle the word serve. And that's why we are called doulos. Because we serve. Amen? Sino dito ikaw ay doulos? Amen? That you know deep inside your heart, the blood running inside your heart is purely a servant. Amen? Amen? You know, I'm a servant. I'm a servant leader. I'm here to serve others. Amen. You know, guys, we cannot do things alone. Lagi nga sinasabi ng ating mga pastor na huwag kang gumawa ng sarili mong mundo dahil mahal ang mundo. Wala pang nakakabili ng mundo. You need to be part of a family. You need to be part of something. You need to be part of a vision. You know, it saddens me a lot when every time I see people just go inside the church, and then after a while, they will pull out themselves and they will just simply leave the church without simply experiencing what is really in store for them. Na nawawala yung pagkakataon na ma-experience nila yung ano inihanda sa kanila ng Panginoon, simply because they don't want to grow roots. They just want to pull themselves. Pero who among you guys would make a commitment na, ako, I know, 25 years, doulos has celebrated, another 25 years. Fifth golden anniversary, will you be here? Amen. Or forever. Amen. Amen? And that's the thing that God wants to impart sa akin. Sabi ko, when I was there in Cuneta and seeing how grand and how festive the celebration was and how passionate our pastors were sharing, sabi ko, Lord, I would like to be here until the rest of my life. And the same thing, I'm seeing the people around, sabi ko, Lord, my prayer is that every one of these people will also grow in their faith sa kanilang pananampalataya. But you know, guys, this one thing, you cannot do it alone. Kailangan mo ng taong makakatulong sa'yo para lumago ka sa iyong pananampalataya. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, you can never do it alone. You need someone to help you to grow in your faith. And remember, guys, that your abilities is for the benefit of other people. God created you for you to bless, for you to be an encouragement to other people. I'll give you two things, dalawang bagay, two pointers for you to become successful in this area. Number one, build your strength so that your weaknesses becomes irrelevant. Build your strength so that your weaknesses becomes irrelevant. Most of people do this. Ano ba yung strength mo? Doon ka mag-focus. Huwag doon sa mga weaknesses mo. Sometimes, and a lot of people would see all the negative things and yet forget what they are good at. So, tingnan mo, saan ka ba magaling? In that way, you know how you will contribute. Kung alam mo kung saan ka magaling, you know where you can go and be a blessing. Amen? I'll give you two practical things. Paano natin i-apply itong bagay na ito? Number one, be part of a ministry. You know, this is what a lot of people inside the church misses, to become part of a ministry. Most of the people just go inside, nagbe-bench warm lang tayo, hawakan mo yung upuan mo, hawakan mo. Diba, ang init na? Kasi nagpapainit ka lang talaga ng upuan. Sumama ka sa ministry and you would enjoy it. Be part of a ministry, something that would bring out your talent. Sino dito yung, you know, guys, crossover, grabe. Yung presentation nila ng pagkain, doon ilalabas yung mga culinary expertise. Doon sumali ka, di ba? Or if you are fond of photography, why don't you express your photography ideas and sumali ka sa multimedia? Or if you want to join the technical team, di ba? Or if you want the hospitality and the ushering team, cryogenics, music team, don't miss the time. Ito ang nangyayari. Ang nangyayari, tinutula ka pa ng cell group leader mo. Sali ka na. Ayoko. Sali ka na. Ayoko. Sali ka na. Alam mo, pag tinutula ka, pinipilit ka, mahirap yun. Kasi at any time, you would, walang commitment. Pero if you volunteer, show up and tell, sabi mo, halimbawa, sa ushering, I want to be part of the ushering team. Okay, paano ba to? Diba? Amen? So, it requires volunteerism. Hindi yung pinilit. Tama? Amen. Sino dito yung, you know, I have something, I have a talent. Amen? Siguro, music team. Diba? Siguro sa pagkanta, siguro sa pagsayaw. Siguro sa pagtanaw ng juice. Or, depende, marami. Diba? Amen. Kung ano man ang talent mo, ibahagi mo ito. And that's one thing where you would see and it will build your strength. And now, yung mga weaknesses mo, hindi mo na nakikita masyado. Ang nangyayari kasi, we dwell so much on the things that we don't have. Wala ka nga noon. Amen? Yung wala ka, huwag kang mag-dwell doon. Mag-dwell ka doon sa bagay na meron ka. Amen. Whatever that you have, resources, skills. And remember, guys, this is the thing that a lot of Christians misses. Hindi lang yung mabuild yung kanilang skill because they join a ministry. Hindi lang yung mabuild yung kanilang character because they're part of that ministry. But you misses the part of meeting new people inside the church. Pansinin mo, ang kilala mo lang sa simbahan, 10. Yung katabi mo, hindi mo nga siya nakilala eh. Kilala mo na yung katabi mo? Nakamaya mo ba siya? Nakilala mo ba siya? Diba? Now, if you're part of a ministry, you would know a lot of people inside the church. You will be connected to the leadership. You will be connected to the leadership of the church. Kamaya mo yung katabi mo, kilalanin mo. Baka hindi mo pa siya kilala. Amen. Now, not only that, hindi lang mag-impart tayo ng ministry, yung pangalawang practical thing, in order for us to build our strength, very practical, ginagawa na natin ngayon, be part of the 90 Days Challenge. You know, we're here in this challenge, and challenges brings out the best in each person. Dapat may konting ano eh, may konting challenge, may pressure, may nangyayari sa buhay natin. Be part of whether you're a deer challenge, sheep challenge, whether you're in the lion, the eagle, or the ox challenge. Sino dito yung part ka ng 90 Days Challenge? Amen. And I'm so blessed to see last week anniversary yung mga champions natin. They were inawardan sila, and who's thinking right now? December. Amen. Sino dito? December, you know. Amen. Who wants to be 90 Days Challenge champion naman? Amen. Parang hindi excited. Amen? Yeah. So, we know na itong challenge na to. Sabi ng isa ko disciple yesterday, di katar natin, no? Sabi niya, Kuya, hindi ako makatin ng morning prayer kasi alis tayo ng maaga, 6 o'clock. Paano na yun? Mamimiss ko yung isang araw. That's how cautious he is. Na isang araw ayaw niya mamiss. Sabi ko, siguro pwede ka mag-pray sa bus. Considered na siguro yun na 90 days na morning prayer. Talaga, Kuya? Sige, tatanong ko kung ganun siya ka-cautious. Amen? So, sino dito... because of this 90 Days Challenge, natututo ka magbasa ng Bible. Diba? You know na how to share the gospel. Nakapag-open ka ng bank account. Amen? May nangyari ba? So, dito ka mag-engage on the things where you will build your strength so that your weaknesses will be irrelevant. Amen. Number two, key to success is that we need to team up with people who will bring out the best in you. Team up with people who will compliment you. Team up with people who will bring out the best in you. Everybody has something to contribute. Nothing has it all. We need each other. Sumama ka sa isang grupo na kung saan alam mo na mapapabuti ka, alam mo na dadaling ka sa tama. The big question is, how would I know that these people will bring out the best in me? Paano? Simple lang. If these people have an active relationship with God, active, not passive. Kasi sometimes, you will be with people who are telling that Christian sila, pero hindi pala Christian. Kasi dadaling ka sa kapamakan. Kailangan yung may active relationship sa God. Alam mo yung tao na yun, nag-grow din sa kanyang spiritual life. Tingnan mo yung katabi mo. Sa palagay mo, nag-grow ba yan? Pag nag-grow yung tao na yan, kumapit ka sa kanya, sumama ka sa kanya. You know, these people will bring out the best in each and every one of us. And who are these people? These will be your leaders, your discipler, your senior pastor. You know, I'm so blessed to have wonderful leaders in my life. Grabe, sobra akong nabibless kasi I know that God appointed someone in my life. God connected me to someone in which it will bring out the best in me. Amen. Sometimes kasi, yung mga ayaw natin sa leader natin eh. Yung naiinis ka pag tinitext ka, pag nitext ka, halap na naman ako. Pag nakita mo yung pangalan, open tas close agad. Diba? Tapos pagpasok mo ng church, hanapin mo yung leader mo. Saan yung leader ko? Andun siya. Kala mo, tatabihan mo eh, no? Andun siya, doon ako uupo. Kasalungat eh. Amen? Sino dito mahal mo yung leader mo? Oos. Totoo? Or, pag goal na, bayan, goal na naman. Puro na lang goal. Amen. Mas pag lagi kang sinecheck, o ka mo sa devotion, okay po. Nakapag-devotion, patingin ng notebook. Okay nga po eh. Sige, patingin nga. Nakalimutan ko po. O, dali mo bukas ha. Kinabukasan. Asa yung notebook mo? Kalimutan ko po eh. Kasi tas kinabukasan na sa notebook mo, ang ginawa mo from day one ng devotion, sinulat mo lahat. Kasi alam mo, i-check ka. So, wrong motive. Amen? Pero sino dito, mahal na mahal mo yung kakulitan ng iyong cell group leader. Amen? You know, guys, this is a funny story. I was like you. When I was new in my faith, ako'y may mga panahon na pagpapasaway din. I remember this classic story. Mahaba ang buhok ko noon hanggang dito. Long hair ako noon. When I was in college, sabi sa akin ni Pastora Geraldine, ano ba yung itsura mo? Hindi ko mawari kung ano ka ba. Ang ginawa niya, tinanong niya ako, magkano ba pagpapagupit? Sabi ko, Pastora, 50 pesos po. Ah, 50 pesos. I guess Pastora gave me 500 that time. Sabi niya, sige, ito. Magpagupit ka, tapos magmerienda ka na rin. Sabi ko, okay. So, pagkakuha ko ng pera, ang ginawa ko, hindi ako nagpagupit. Nagmerienda lang ako. Pagkakita ko yung Pastora Jer, sabi niya, akala ko nagpagupit ka na. You know, Pastor, so patient with me during that time. And sabi niya sa akin, magpagupit ka. Ito uli ang pera, magpagupit ka. Sabi ko, sisip ko, ayos to ah. Libreng merienda na naman. But you know, guys, sabi ko, with so much patience, with so much love and grace and all the favor, grabe, God changed me from that time until this day. Ang daming binago sa akin ng Panginoon. Alam ko, makulit ako, pero grabe tindi ng pasensya sa akin ng mga leader ko to bring out the best in me. At kayo, huwag kayong mapapagod kung makukulit yung mga leaders ninyo. Amen. Amen? Sino dito, love na love mo cell group leader mo? Amen. Ilibre mo mamaya. Puro ka na lang amen eh. Lagyan natin application. Amen. So, be connected with your cell group leader. Be connected with the church. Be connected with the senior pastor na kung ano yung gustong gawin ng simbahan, let's do this as a team. Let's advance whatever needs to be advanced. Let's advance the kingdom of God. Amen. Amen? Number two, not only your cell group leader, but God wants you to be connected with a cell group. He don't want you to miss that opportunity to be part of a small group. Kasi doon sa small group, this will be the place that you will find friends, this will be the place where it would complement, will bring out the best in you. You should take care. Take care of one's back, not biting it. Ang nangyayari kasi, salip na magtulungan, nagkakasakitan. You know, a cell group is a place where you would compensate each other and not compromise with sin. Amen? You do not hide sin inside the cell, but you would expose sin, what's ever happening. Amen? Kung mayroong kasalanan or may nagkakasala, you expose that person, but still, you love the person. Tama? Galit ka sa kasalanan, pero yung tao, mahal na mahal mo. Amen? Because sa loob ng cell group, God wants na yung loob ng cell group na yun, na this group will bring out yung galing, yung magle-level up tayo as a group. And that's God's design doon sa mga cell groups natin. Amen? So, sino dito, ikaw part ka ng cell group? Amen. You know, guys, ako sobra akong nag-i-enjoy sa loob ng cell group. We're having meetings every Tuesday na mga primary. And I always find and make sure that even though how busy I am sa trabaho, ako po ay nagtatrabaho 8 hours, minsan nag-overtime pa ako. Though I am tired na sa trabaho, I know I will be seeing my discipler, I will be seeing yung mga primary, and I'm excited. Dapat ganun din tayo. Are you excited when every time that you see your leader, when every time that you see yung mga ka-cell group mo? Yung iba kasi, dyan na naman siya. Ayoko siyang makita. Pero alam mo, dapat mabago na yung buhay natin, mabago na yung kaisipan natin. Yesterday was really something. Kahapon, yung water baptism and the family outing, a lot of people enjoy. Amen. Ay, nag-enjoy ba dito? Grabe, sobrang daming pagkain, hilera. Tapos yung iba, pagkatapos ng water baptism, nag-banana boat kami ni na Pastor June. Ako, si Pastor June, si Romeo, si Kuya Franz, at saka si Albert. Hindi nakasakay ako. Ayoko ng mga extreme talaga. Ako'y makakabahin. Kaya sabi ko kay Kuya, Kuya, slow down lang ha. Slow down. Eh, hindi nakikinig si Kuya. Ang bilis talaga. Rat-rat talaga yung banana boat. Kuya, slow down. Ayaw niya makinig. Ang bilis niya. Tapos talagang, ipiflip niya talagang ganun. Sabi ko, wow, this is life. Yeah, let's get it on. Sabi ni Kuya, meron pa isa pa. Akala ko tapos na Kuya. Isa pa daw. Kinabahan ako. Sabi ko sa mga ka-network ko, kayo nang bahala sa network natin. Alagaan niyo yung mga disciple na ha. Nilibiro ko sila. It was really fun. And who says that Christianity is boring? Di ba? Boring ba Christianity? Hindi, no? We spend the weekend at beach. Yeah. Amen? That's Christianity, man. You know, you would experience the goodness of God and how beautiful a relationship inside the church if you're part of a cell group. So don't miss that part. Huwag mong i-miss yung part na hindi ka kasama sa loob ng cell group. Amen? So, who among you guys love watching war movies? Yung mga war movies. I love watching war movies, especially yung mga old times na mga war movies. So wherein, ang inaabangan ko parati sa war movies, yung mga formation na gagawin. One of the most famous formation na mga tao, bago pala ang formation, the captain would ask yung kanyang lieutenant, so, how many barrels do we have? And the lieutenant was, we only have 20,000 barrels, but the enemy has 30,000. We know we can defeat them. Ganun. Sabi ko, ito na, labanan na. Patayan na talaga, sabi ko. And one thing that I am looking forward dun sa mga war movies, yung mga formation nga. One of the formation na lagi nakikita ko yung wall formation o yung fortress wherein all the soldiers would combine shields. Magdidikit-dikit yung mga yan. And shields during that time ay mga malalaki. It will cover the whole body. We will cover the whole body, just like what the Bible is telling, the shield of faith. It would cover yourself and the person right beside you. So the captain would shout, wall formation, and they would combine each other, naka-wall. Wala ngayon makapag-penetrate dun sa wall na yun. And then when the captain would say, attack, on the slit of those shield, lalabas yung mga sword nila and they would just simply kill the enemy. You know guys, lagi ko sinasabi sa mga disciple ko, walang hindi kaya ang mga Kristiyano pag nagsama-sama. We can do everything. We can defeat everything. In this battle, you don't need to be alone. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, huwag kang loner. Kailangan natin yung bawat isa. And one also of the formation na gusto ko sa mga war movies, yung turtle formation. Wherein, it will be a fortress, a wall, and then there will be a wall at top. So magkakaroon naman ng mga shield sa taas. For the flaming arrows, hindi makatama sa kanila. You know, Satan is very cunning. He would oppose you, kill you in every sides. Pero simply because you have people that would protect you in all areas of your life, would cover you, you know that you're safe. Amen? Kaya dapat lagi kang konektado doon sa mga taong alam mo makakatulong sa'yo. Tama po ba? Amen. Huwag mong i-disconnect ang sarili mo. Huwag mong i-disconnect ang sarili mo. Get root sa loob ng simbahan. Amen. Amen? So, we know that we should take care of each other. We should compensate our weaknesses and not hiding it. We should compensate with each other, I mean, and yung mga weaknesses natin, we should make sure na ma-unleash talaga natin yung mga potential doon sa mga bagay na yun, sa mga areas na yon. This is where I would end. You know, guys, my life as a Christian, it's been a long journey, 13 taon sa Dulos for Christ, and I see how the church grew, how from that small group of people until this day, sabi ko, Lord, salamat kasi I have been in this journey and I've seen how our pastor worked tirelessly and how the pastor loved this church so much. You know, gaya ninyo, nung ako'y bagatang Kristiyano, there are moments also in my Christian life where I am so fired up, sobrang tindi ng gigil ko noon. Attend ako ng Wild Sons. Lahat ng Wild Sons, ina-attendan ko. I'll be in every camps. I'll be attending in every conferences and revivals. But you know, yung buhay pananampalataya, it's not always like super hype. There are many times na I feel low. There are times na it's really low, low, low. But the thing that I really liked about, yung sinabi ko doon sa nagtanong sa akin, for how long I've been inside the church, and sabi ko sa kanya, two things why I'm still here. Because God loves me so much, and I love Him also. And I know na hindi ako makahiwalay, hindi ako makaseparate doon sa pagmamahal ng Diyos sa akin. It always pulls me back from where I should be. And pangalawa, meron ako mga taong nakapaligid sa akin na I know that there are people who always reinforce me and always people who gives me hope, chance, people who would tell na kaya mo yan. And sabi ko, Lord, if without these people, I cannot do it. There are times na alala ko na if I'm spiritually not okay, I would go and I would approach pastor or bishop rin. I would ask na, Pastor, can you pray for me? I know for a fact that there are no like instant answer or there's no evident answer after that prayer. But what assures me on that time, I know there's people who always there, who stands beside me. Alam ko, mayroong mga taong nandiyan parati para sa akin. And I can still continue on. There was one time in my life, it was really a low part of my life. Sabi ko, Lord, I would like to make it a call. Ayoko na, alis na ako. I've been here and I'm tired. Physically tired, emotionally tired. I don't like anymore. It's like time for me to quit, sabi kong ganun. And I remember the time when Bishop Ariel talked to my disciples. Ang sabi niya, itong mga panahon na ito, kailangan ni Kuya Darwin ninyo ng mercy ninyo. Ibigay niyo yun sa kanya. Dahil darating ang panahon na kayo naman ang mga kailangan ng mercy ni Kuya Darwin at hindi niya ipagkakait sa inyo. When I heard that words from my pastor, I say na, this is how compassionate these people are. These people who always there, whenever time that you fail, they always give you hope for you to keep on going and going. Probably you're a person right now, you've been attending here, been way long attending in this church, na wala na yung passion, you're just simply like dead man walking, simply going here. And missing that point na meron kang simbahan, meron kang pamilyang nagmamahal sa'yo, meron kang mga taong naniniwala sa'yo, you know that these people cares for you so much, and these people wants you to be on the place where God wants you to be. Do not miss that opportunity. Do not miss that opportunity na may mga taong nagtitiwala sa'yo kahit anong nangyari, kahit anong failure mo pa, they're still there for you. Ang sabi ng Bible, so for us, that's 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Therefore, encourage one another and build up one another just as you are doing. You know, this is the very time na the church should unite. We, as a church, should unite. And mapakita natin, may paramdam natin kung gaano tayo kamahal ng Panginoon. Probably you're the person na sobra kang fired up ngayon. You're okay spiritually. Be an encouragement. Be a blessing. Tap someone's shoulder and sabi mo sa kanya, I'm standing in faith with you. Kaya natin yan. We will go and we would finish this race. Amen. Amen. Who among you guys, your commitment is to stand in faith, to live for Christ, not only for the next 25 years, but forevermore. Amen. Amen? Is that your commitment? If that's your commitment, I want you to stand on your feet right now, and we'll be praying. And we'll be thanking God for this church, and for everyone. Yung mga kasama mo, yung mga katabi mo, papasalamatan natin, Lord, salamat, dinala mo ko sa simbahang ito na alam ko yung church na ito, tutulong sa akin sa buhay pananampalataya, sa aking buhay pananampalataya. You know, guys, I may not know each and everyone's situation right now. Probably, you're in a very difficult situation. But this is just, I would like to encourage everyone na God loves you so much. He has the best plan for you. It's not an accident that why God appointed people to be connected to you. Because these people will help you. You simply approach these people. Siguro mag-ask ka, can you pray for me? Because these people, inassign talaga sila ng Panginoon to be a blessing to your life. At ikaw din. God wants you to be a blessing also to other people. Amen? That's why we are church. That's why we are called doulos. Amen? Amen? Why don't we just give a clap of praise to our God and simply thank God for the family, for this church. Amen. Lord, salamat, salamat po, Panginoon. For you have appointed us, for you have bring us, Lord God, on a church, Lord God, where we know where we would grow, Lord God. Lord God, I pray that you would bless each and everyone. Why don't we just thank the Lord right now? Simply thank Him for this spiritual family. Lord God, maraming salamat po sa buhay po ni Pastor, ni Bishop Ariel Panginoon, Pastor Geraldine. Thank you for our spiritual parents, Lord God, who always dare to stand for us, Lord God, who always dare to direct us, to give us the right vision, Lord God, the right path, Lord God. Today, Lord God, we are in one heart with our leaders, Lord God. Salamat, Panginoon, dinala niyo po kami sa mga cell groups. Meron po kami mga spiritual, meron po kami mga God-appointed leaders doon sa aming mga cell group, Lord God. Today, Lord God, ang panalangin po namin, maging blessing din po kami, Panginoon. Lord God, I just don't know, Lord God, yung mga situation ng mga kapatid ko sa pananampalataya, pero, Lord, what I just know is that you love these people and you want the best for these people. Lord God, today, Lord God, we are one in heart with you, Lord God. Today, I pray that you would simply touch the lives of these people, Lord God. Whatever things are happening, Lord God, sa life po nila, send someone that would encourage them, Lord God. Magdala po kayo ng mga tao na magbibigay sa kanila ng encouragement. If there are people right now, Lord, na like those on the cliff of giving up, Lord God, Lord, I pray that, Lord, you would simply send someone to help them, Lord God. Lord, we as a church, we know, Lord God, that you have the best plan for us. And your plan for us is for us to advance your kingdom, Lord God. We will connect ourselves, Lord God. Magsasama-sama po kami to fulfill, Lord God, whatever that you want us to fulfill, Lord God. We know we need each other, Lord God. We need you most in our lives, Lord God. Be the Lord and the Savior, the center of our lives, Jesus. Salamat po, Panginoon, for everything. We love you and we honor you. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. Amen.